या हेलो,
हेलो।
Sachin is joining us in a moment. Yeah, I think you can go ahead for this one. Go ahead, Sachin is actually.
So, first of all, I would like to welcome Mr. Gautam. Welcome to the session, webinar session, and I'll start with introducing the team to you, and then we can go ahead with the session.
Okay.
We have with us Mr. Ravi Kiran Tanali. I hope you know him very well. He is the founder and CEO of SMC.
Yes.
He has worked at Olympics and US as head of operation and head of volunteers. Then we have our volunteers with us, Sonam Patra, Sunaina, and Sachin. And myself, Pratishtha Bhalla. I'm a mind and memory coach and I'm a partner at SMC. Today, we have a session with us with founder and CEO of Bangalore Soccer Academy, Mr. Gautam Devnath. He started Bangalore Soccer Academy, BSG, with a vision to train upcoming soccer talents and develop outstanding achievements at national and international level. He has represented Mohammedan Sporting, Air India, HAL, and Vasco FC in the league. He is also the member of National Champions West Bengal from 2000 to 2004, and he has represented West Bengal in the under 19 and under 21 national champions team. So welcome, Mr. Devnath, and the session is all yours now.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, tell me what I need to tell you. My journey is I started Bhatri Shanga, and that is in Super Division, my coach in Sabir Ali, and then almost 10 years I played in Calcutta in continue. That is, I played in Eastern Rail, I played Bhatri Shanga in Second Division I League, then I played in Modern Sporting in 2003-2004, then finally I jumped again in 2007 and 8 and 9. I played in Air India. That time onwards, I mean, outside Calcutta, almost in 13, 14 years. Then I settled in Bangalore 2010. And then I started my academy 2010, almost in 10 years over in my academy in Bangalore Soccer Galaxy, and near about 400-500 students is there, 11 branches in Bangalore. Orchid, all the branches in our under, and that is Orchid, all the branches we are doing in after school activity and between school activity, and now our Super Division girls team is there, and they are this year fifth position. And girls under 17, we are champion in Karnataka. And our boys grassroots level, they are going doing in very good. And this year, I think in a DPA DL, which one is a baby league and all, they are in third position. They're doing good. And 2018, we are journey in. I went Sweden, participate in Gothia Cup, and that result also is very good. And keep on doing that one. And this year, I think we are on to take in one fifth division club in KSFA. Let's see. Our residential is there, near about 10 to 12 boys. And Manipuri boys are there, Assam boys and all. And let's hope in the future is I can do something in contributing Indian football. That is that purpose I'm doing. That is my mission only.
That's great to know. Sir, the topic for today was building a successful sports career. So what are your opinions on the future of sports and how one can build a career in sports?
See, Indian football, in my suggestion, I played in club level and Indian level. My opinion in that is in more competition should be want, more competition. Is a very less competition in grassroots level. And that is in few now, it started, I think, 2 years back in baby league and all those things. That it should be in more early and more competition in grassroots level. That is in a, like a 8 years, 9 years, 10 years. Then they can jump in a under 13 I league and all. And that is great help in future their performance and all. That is my opinion.
Okay, if somebody wants to go into football, how does they do they start? Do they need to start at a very early age? What should be the correct age for a child to start playing?
See, outside country also they are starting in 4 years and 5 years. I think in India is starting that one. In now only they are doing that one, and that is good things only. There is 4 5 years need to start. And then slowly their journey can make in, at least in 4 5 years when they are spending in time in grassroots level, then definitely they are more confident they can get in a top level.
So the child should start training at a very early age of 5 years, yes. And then that they will be able to play.
Yeah.
Then if a child starts like 10 or 12 years of age, then how should they speed up? Like how do they compete with the kids who have started early?
See, started early, then they are their agility and all those things is a very good. In that time, you can work their basic, like a push, a normal push in. What happened? No, I travel in outside country and all. I saw in our Indian standard, they don't know in how to trap and how to pass. And their passing style is very slowly they are pushing. Still, they are not in habituate in hard push and good trapping. Indian football is lacking in that area also. Because of that, when they can start in small age, suppose our academy is doing that, is in 4 5 years. And they should habituate in football in two things. That is in good trapping and good pass. And say that things is not happening, then definitely you can't play in a good football. And when is a 10 years, 12 years, they don't know how to tight their ankle, how to they are turning their passing and how to wait up pass. All those things is very difficult. And when they are starting in 10 years, see 1 or 2 years inside, they need to play in I-League and all. Otherwise, it's a next level they can't achieve. That is one gap is happening in Indian football.
Can that be attributed to the way the sports is being considered in India till now because of the lack of opportunities? We know that very few players get the opportunity to play at a national or international level. So parents always have this thing in mind that the kids should study first. Mm-hmm. So how do you think this can be changed and what role can we as an academy play to promote more of sports?
Yeah, see, one thing you see, every time one education, one good things is everybody in grow on a purpose, that is, you need to do that one. But sports is like what I tell you, not in everybody purpose. Few members is that is like they need to do in more hard work, and people now don't want to do that one. See, every child, they are want in a sitting home inside, they are watching in TV and all those things. See, professional football, at least in 6-7 hours, suppose you're not spending in a time in a ground inside, you're not in a proper dedicated, and you are not in that much good quality of player. See, nowadays in children, that is the thing, is one lacking. They are don't want to practice in 1 or 1.5 hours also. They are not in spending in a time in football. They are wanting a very, what I tell you, sitting home inside. There is a rest too much, and they are not in junk food and all those things they are doing. And finally, they are not able to get in a good strength in a ground inside. And that is one lacking thing, sir. And see, that purpose, individually, we need to focus, academy need to focus in a sports purpose, and need to go ahead.
So tell us about more about Bangalore Soccer Galaxy, what role it had played in shaping up the kids in football, how they you have brought kids out of their home to play football.
See, we are now organizing in a more like a inter competition, and small children, no, they are want in a more matches in a, suppose you are doing in a 15 days continuum practice session and all those things, and they are sometimes they are lacking in their that thing, so especially in soccer, why you know more running, more passing and more physically, then that time, no, they are don't want to do that one. And when I'm telling you, okay, next 15 days one match is there, or inter competition in academy, or outside any tournament, that time they are coming and they are given more into in practicing, sir. And that thing is needed in every academy. See, our academy is doing every 15 days inter one competition is there, that is in 4-5 branches our, and then suppose you say that is MOFA, then we are doing in a that academy same branches in a tournament or something kind of thing. We are doing that one. Then competition is there, definitely that small children getting in a more into, and they are doing in a more practice.
Okay. What is the role of a coach in the life of the students? Like, what is the role of a coach according to you?
Yeah, coach is what I tell you, coach always in role model. Coach can give in a more dedicated, and a coach should be in a more, what I'll tell you, more friendly. Nowadays, is coaches really, is a good coaches getting in a very, very difficult. That is a very lacking things is there in our, why no? I see All India Football Federation, what they have started. You see, anybody can do that license and doing coaching and all, and they're coming in into in sports. That is one lacking thing is there, in my opinion. Why no? See, supposing normal people or software people or something like that. In Bangalore, I saw in so many software guys, they are start doing in a license. Like they are doing in a license. They are, what I'll tell you, in small football, they are played A division or fifth division, fourth division. Then now they are working in a software. And then suddenly they are interchange their things, and they are coming for license, and they are doing. Then finally they are not concentrated in an individual child. See, one coach is like a role model. You need to know each and everything, and you need to give in more energy in ground inside. You need to think about that. Then you can change a good environment in ground inside. That is one lacking piece is there nowadays. That is, I'm also struggling. I'm doing in a here. See, getting in a good coach is very, very difficult in Bangalore.
You raised a very great point that there is a lack of good coaches. So what do you think is the exact gap? Like, how can we reduce that gap for the having better coaches for the students as well as future athletes?
Yeah, future athletes. See, one thing in that is in a local association can do that one, who are playing in a good football. They are in a after 10 or 15 years. See, outside country, what happening, no? When you're playing, and they are starting their license also in same way. Say they continue, they are doing that one also. And finally, when they are finishing, like retirement of in a football life or soccer, any sports life, and they can jump their coaching career also. But India, what happened? India, who are playing in a football, then finally were left their football career, then they are not finishing their certificate and all. And then again, they are doing, you know, they are spending in a time 3 or 4 years in a certificate. Then finally, more gap is happening in between. And KSFA or which one is there in a local association, they need to more concentrate senior who are playing in a football, and they need to do according to in license and all. They need to do that one.
So you are saying that only the players who have already played should be become the coach of that particular sport, and basically.
Yeah. Why I'm telling you, say, suppose you're playing in a good football, then you need to know about in a player, understand and quality of player and how to do in basic in grassroots level is they don't know in a few coaches I saw in that one. They don't know in how to push only and they don't know how to juggle. See, coach always in role model. Suppose as a coach, I don't know is how to juggle in 10 or 15. Then player also not able to do that one.
Yes, but there has been some statistics, and like the people who have already played, the people who have already played are not necessarily the best coaches, because for coaching there is a different level of skill that is required. So to become a coach, do you think that they should undergo another training so that they can train for their mindset as well? Because just knowing the game is not enough when you are doing being a coach.
Yeah, that is the thing. See, every coaches is not like that, but they are need to play a certain level in a football career. Certain level, at least you need to you can achieve. Then you can understand what is going on and what is the basic things. And what is the how to treat in players? They need to know about that. That's why that is my point.
So, is there anybody having a question with Gautam? Before I ask any more questions, is there anyone who would like to put a question?
No.
Please, Sonam, I think, wants to ask. Please unmute and ask.
No, I don't have any question. Actually, it's been addressed already. The question which I wanted to ask was about the coaching. But then it was already addressed. So, I don't have any question now.
Okay. Gautam, if somebody wants to become a football player, football coach, then how do they start according to you? Like if they have, say they don't have that much experience, still they want to become a coach, then how should they start?
They need to more time. They need to spend in time within children and ground. They need to learn their basic things. First of all, now I think in All India Football Federation started, I think E and D license that is. And they need to go ahead that all the license. And they need to spend in more time. As a coach, you need to work within children. I need to understand their psychology, and they need to understand their basic things. They need to spend more time. Nowadays, coaches, what happened? No, they are like our coaches. I'm talking about in our coaches, they are like a 24 hours coach. Why? No, they are checking in behind also. Home inside, what are you doing? We are eating and all those things. They are in following each and everything. Like they are in 24 hours coaching. But nowadays, what they are doing in a license and they are coming for in coaching and all, there is like a 2 hours coaching, coach. After coaching, they are not thinking about children. They are not thinking about, 20 children I practice. And then after practice, they are not thinking about, these children is lacking is there, or I need to improve in that guy. Individually, they are not thinking about it. That is the thing. So that's why I'm telling you, you see, as a player, suppose you are a coach, then you start thinking, your senior coaches are doing that one. Okay, next, you need to do that level. Okay, I need to follow up. Okay, if that guy is spending more time in TV inside or mobile gadget inside. You need to talk and you need to understand their psychology also. That's why my point
That's a really good point.
Yeah. Yeah, you should commit it. As a coach, you need to commit it. That is in 10 to 12 hours. You need to spend time within children. And you need to ask their behind what they are doing. And study also. See, our coaches also, same thing. They are calling before is no phone, nothing is there. But they are coming in my house or something like that. They are coming in weekly once. And they are checking, hey, you're doing a study and all. See, all these things is very important. Why that purpose, I'm telling you, the coach always in role model. And he should need to behind always in player, then become a one good player you can get in Indian football. Otherwise, not so easy.
So you are saying that there should be clear communication between the coach and the coachee, and they should have a very good rapport so that they can understand each other's point.
Correct.
That is a very valid point.
Yeah,
so we have a question here. How are we keeping you? How are you keeping your students or kids engaged during this lockdown? What are you doing to keep them engaged?
Our always in online classes are there. Really, who are our like a special one batch is there? Who are like a 10 years, 11 years, and 12 years? Who are they are playing in this year in I League in under 13? All our under 13 boys in 10, 11, 12 years boys. And their online classes are there in this lockdown, whole lockdown. And especially I'm only taking that one. And their meditation classes are there. And their physical activity, strength training, each and everything I'm doing in online.
Okay, so are they still interested? Because I have met several parents who are always having this problem that our kids won't study online. We don't want to teach them online. So playing is a whole different game. So like 1 year back, if somebody would have asked me, would you like to play, learn playing online? I would have said no, but now it is the reality. So how did you cope up with this thing that they had in mind?
Yeah, children is definitely, they are on to run, they are on to play in a ground and free things they are one. But what to do? That is the situation in came in India. You need to do that one. And you need to talk. That's why I'm talking with each and everybody. I told her, see, now you're 6, 7 months or 8 months after you, suppose your I-League is there. What do you do? How your preparation? That's why that is the thing. You need to talk with each and everybody. And they are, should understand in my mind and their mind, I need to understand. And I'm talking with each and everybody. Then meditation classes, stretching, strength training, each and everything. And they are happily. And they are doing almost 20 kids, our special batch inside. And they are doing very well.
That's amazing to know. So are you also doing some training for the coaches? Is there a program for them?
Yeah, our Sunil is there, our head of youth. Sunil is a B license holder. Sunil is there, and one C license called Emmanuel is there. They are doing all those things. They are sit within 15 days once, or outside some coaches are sometimes coming in a foreign coach. They are doing that one in coaches training, then how to do in drill. How to implement all the drill, and then suppose in according to player, you need to change your drill in every time. You need to think, and that is the things he's doing now.
Okay, that's really great to know. Gautam, can we take you a little back? I would like to know more about your journey now. Can you tell us the biggest struggle you faced when you started your academy, and how you overcome that?
Yeah, our academy. You see, I started in orphanage boys. That is in our HL near. I played in HL. I'm staying in HL quarters. I'm behind. I saw in one like Anandpuram one area. That is all orphanage boys, and they are playing very good and outstanding there. And they are playing in a BR foot. And I'm in HL that time. Then slowly I started with them, and that is in free of cost. Each and everything I want to spend with them. And then almost in 40, 42 kids, and I think in a more than I think 20 girls. At that time, and then I started slowly into that is in professional. Then I one more branch I opened that time. Slowly I started, and definitely one challenge. See, I'm in Calcutta boy, and they don't want to do. I means what they are not given any support to do. You open any academy. One challenge is there in Bangalore. See, you're not you don't know in Canada. Then they are not thinking about you. Okay, like that. That is one big challenge. Still now, I think when I started in school and all, then slowly I learned in Canada. A little I start talking with them. then they are, oh, okay, that guy is no in Canada and all. That is one big challenge in Bangalore. I feel that. Then slowly people are recognized. And I played in Sandostavi in Karnataka only, 2011-12. And people know me in very well. That's why. And now who is a secretary in Satya sir, he's like me too much. He's helping. He's like me. And everybody, now he started. Everybody is doing that one. they are helping me now. Why our player is playing in a national, then last year, our one player in US, SG Academy inside, his name in Kanish, is in US. And this year, we are trying in outside country, in Spain, again, in trial purpose. And the special boys are there. There are few boys that are outstanding. Ritvik is there. He's juggling, he's 9 years boy. He's juggling in 3,000, more than 3,000, 3,300 kind of things. And Nadia is there. He's juggling also more than 2,000. They are in basic. It's too good now. I'm trying. And let's see, is God grace, at least one or two boys I can promote in India or outside country. We are trying in one third division of Spanish club. We are tie up, I think shortly. We are doing that.
Okay, so the biggest challenge you said that you faced was about the language difference. I think that is very common anywhere we go, like, because of different languages. There is a different kind of connection. Like, it's a little difficult if you are in a place you don't know their language. So yeah, so you, along with sports, you learn languages as well. That's great to know. any other challenge specifically related to sports or getting the child at the national level or you face that you would like to share?
No, my academy who are going for it, they are definitely, they are now not in that much either facing there. Why already I already won 10 years I spent in Bangalore. And now I think they are easily, they can go for in national. And our player is going in Calcutta League also in first division. I think last year played in 8 players. I think now easy for them. They can go for in outside country also. Shortly, I think we are tie up means definitely they can go for in outside country also. Now very easy, very, very easy. Our time is a very tough time. I think in 2007-08, my offer in Qatar Al Ameen Club. But visa, everything I done. But Indian football, they don't want to give in a release and all those things. They are very difficult to go in outside country in before. But now is very, very easy way. You can go for in trial in below 10, 16, I think. Easily you can go for anywhere in any country. You can go for in trial and you can prove. Definitely that academy can take you. That is now. Now is very easy way. I think in a now, supposing player, they are supposing dedicated and supposing academy, suppose they are given in more support, more time, and definitely can produce in good players.
So what will be your suggestion to academy which is just trying to start themselves right now? How can they take benefit of the current scenario, since you are saying that now it is easier? And how can they start up?
See, academy, that's why I'm telling you, academy, see, need to follow a few criteria. What I tell you, make assessment, individual player assessment. Who are coach, they need to understand, okay, they need to know what is the speed level, what is the basic in juggling or with ball running or tee running, all those things, whatever test is there. As a coach, you need to know about that. And you need to work at least in 2 or 3 years. Definitely, you can improve. But if you academy, I don't want to mention in any name or anything. See, what they are doing, they are starting one thing. I'll tell you, like a franchisee or kind of things. They are doing that one. What they are doing in taking in one franchisee, and whatever curriculum is coming, they are following that one. That is not in academy job. That you can't follow like that. Thoroughly you can't follow. See, suppose in my player already have that agility, and that is in agility session is coming. And you know that player already have that ability. why are you spending in your time in that one? According to player, you need to make their session plan and their assessment, and you need to share with in parents. We are doing in 2.5 month, every month in parents teacher, 2.5 month is parents teacher meeting is there. I'm calling each and every parent and I'm showing their progress. Suppose you're not showing their progress. So you say, how is the education level is happening in every 3 months, one parents teacher meeting is there and they are showing in a progress in there. Same thing in football also. Suppose you want in a more involved in parents in soccer inside, then definitely you need to show their progress. Suppose in small children, suppose in 4 years or 5 years, suppose he's coming for in spending in a time in 1 hour or 1.5 hour, in weekly 2 days or 3 days. What is his progress in 2.5 months after? Suppose you're not showing in parents, then definitely parents telling, oh, they are doing in a time pass, they are in taking that money and they are doing that one. And that thing should not in happen. That is one lacking is there. Now, Bangalore, I think more than 100 academies there. And most of the what they're doing, they are opening their academy and they are just want to take that monthly fees or quarterly fees and they're spending their time. And finally, 3 or 4 years after, that players is supposed in 5th standard to came in 8th standard. And finally, they are left. Why education pressure is there and they are not showing their progress? Then definitely parents side, definitely they are thinking, oh, progress is not there. Why they are spending in their time in the ground? It's only physical activity purpose they are coming there. That as a academy, see, I'm running in a my own interest. That is, I played in football and that is my passion. I'm doing that one. And definitely I want in a, that is in a very good way and larger way in my academy. But other academy, what they're doing, they are like they want to take in a money. And few, like I can tell you, in Barca, I think more than in 10 players, they are coming in my academy. Why they are coming? There are no that name in Barca academy, but there are, what I'll tell you, they are charged in like 84,000 in yearly, and then finally they are not given in any progressive report or anything. That is the thing. So just one example I give. Like that is there. They need to spend their time, and definitely coaches should be more into and more energetic in ground inside. They need to know their ability, each and every player. Suppose your batch inside as a teacher, in our teacher, suppose in classroom inside 30 member is there, in teacher know the 30 member ability, each and everybody. And that is, as a coach, you need to know that suppose your batch inside in 20 member is there, you need to know in 20 member ability. And 20 member, how you can improve, that is up to you. You need to do their spending your time and you need to improve their game. That is the thing.
These are some really good points. You mentioned that we should measure the progress. So do you have any benchmarks or some progress marking system that you are using?
Yeah. Definitely.
Can you let us know what exactly, how do you do that, or if, will it be possible to explain in the session? How do you measure a progress?
See, one small example, that is, I'm talking about juggling. Suppose juggling is a very, very important in soccer. Why juggling inside concentration is there, juggling your weight of pass, how, where you're touching, and your concentration, each and everything is there in juggling inside. Suppose one player, as a player, you're not doing in juggling. I'm talking about benchmark now. See, UK level, 110 years, boys, in juggle, in near about 100, 100 and 120. Now your benchmark should be in as a 10 years, boy, your juggling should be in a more than 100. Suppose you're not doing, then you can't achieve. Your concentration is less, your touches is less, and your weight of pass, you not understand that one. Then suppose you can, like a divide, like that is, like a, how is a juggling, even speed also, same thing with ball running also, same thing. You can suppose in divide like that, in suppose 10 years boy, as a 10 years boy in 100 meter, I'm talking about 100 meter, that is in 15 to 16 seconds. Suppose you can complete that one, then your good speed is there. You can think about then with ball running, that is in 17 to 18 seconds, you need to finish that one. See, all those things, suppose you can make one benchmark, then definitely every day you can work with. Yeah, it is the thing.
Okay, so these benchmarks are revised, or these are always static?
Yeah, we are doing that one.
That's really great. So there are some questions which the people here wants to ask. The first is, who is your role model?
I'm in Calcutta boy. I'll tell you, I like Sourav Ganguly too much. See, he is not in cricket. He is a cricketer, but he's always my role model. I played in cricket also. In school level, I played in leather ball and all. And my football, I can tell you, in Deepak Mundal, I like too much. And Deepak Mundal is, I'm also played in left back, and he's also in defender as a defender. And he's my role model. And Deepak Mundal, I like it too much. And Torunde, in, I think in his 82-90s player. A few matches I saw, my starting football career in East Bengal Junior. And because of that, I saw them, Alok Mukherjee, Torunde, who are the defender, in good defender. And I saw him in a few matches in Alok Mukherjee, Torunde. Then I saw his Deepak Bhai also. Already that time, I'm also playing with a few matches in Deepak Bhai also. I like it in Deepak Mundal. Is my, as a defender, my role model.
Great to know that, Yashwant. So your question is answered now. So Naina, there is a question for, that you would like to ask. Can you please unmute and ask the question? Okay, so Naina, can you unmute and ask your question?
Hello, sir. I wanted to ask the question.
Yeah.
Yeah. That, as you said, you show the result of progress of every player to parents.
Yeah.
So for that progression, do you take a test? And the coaches who will take
yeah.
that test, are they trained for it?
Yeah, definitely.
Train the coaches for taking
yeah,
that
yeah.
progression test.
Yeah. About, see, every 2.5 months, we are testing almost in, I think, 23 to 26 test results. We are children are go through that one. We are in very good. We who are very good in sports. We are onto as a professional football player. Their go through should be in like the test in every 2 and 2.5 months. And then you can progress yourself. Definitely, we are going like that. Tunaina, you can hear me.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I do.
So, Naina, you also had this question.
So, different kind of level of probe. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, tell me.
So, there is a different, you will take a different test as a progression
yes.
for players.
Yeah.
So, there is any kind of level
yeah.
keeping test level 1, level 2, level
yes,
3.
Yes.
So how you will differentiate that levels? Can you
See,
just tell the coaches so that we will have a good explanation?
See, just now I told you, 10 years boy, their juggling should be in 100, 120. Okay. Next, suppose in 12 to 13 years or 13 to 15 years boy, they are juggling more than 250 to 300. And suppose in 13 years boy, then they are juggling in more than in 500. But me in my academy, 9 years boy, they are juggling in more than 3,000. That is one different level is there. And you need to understand in player concept and player dedication. Definitely, you should make your benchmark, you know, also more higher. See, who that Ritwik, one guy is there. Arya is there. Sidhu, one guy is there. I'm making in their benchmark, in a more higher. Suppose they are juggling in the first 1 month, in they are achieving 500, then definitely next 3 months, what I'm doing, your juggling level in should be in more than in 1,500. And now because of that Ritwik and all, they are juggling in a 9 years boy, they are juggling in more than, I have that video and all, definitely next time I'll share with everybody. And they are juggling in more than in 3,500. As a coach,
sure.
you need to understand. And you need to make more higher one level. Then definitely they are make their challenge and they are, want to achieve that one.
Yeah. Okay.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, sir. Just one request on behalf of SMC or Tenali Sports. I would like to request you that if you can provide us some sort of Excel file or some sort of guidance to our coaches so that they can benchmark their things. And they can have a plan for their students, the actual progression plan on monthly basis. So if you can guide us some sample worksheet or sample templates, it would be great. Correct, Sunaina?
Definitely.
So I'll get back to the topics for today. So today Yashwant is also asking a question. He's saying that how can a coach create good bonding towards students? So Yashwant, I think Gautam has already given a lot of information on this, that they should communicate and build a good rapport. But Gautam, would you like to add any more points? Because he's very keen to know how to create better bonds.
Yeah, as a coach, you need to talk with, you need to understand. You need to understand their point and their, you need to see, nowadays children are talking, is very talkative, you know, that is the things I'm handling with, you know, very small children. That's why I'm telling you. See, they are very talkative. And suppose you, as a coach, you not listen them. You need to listen. Oh, whatever they are telling. Their whatever their idea. Why not? They are not talking in like a different things, but that they are, whatever they are talking, you need to understand them and give their proper answer. Suppose you don't know that one, you need to think about that, and you need to good idea or good things you need to tell in next day. At least you can give that answer also is okay, but you need to talk with them. They are very talkative. They are need to know why. No, nowadays in children they are. Know each and everything. Whatever skill you ask, they can show you or they can know about in YouTube and all those things. But as a coach, suppose you don't know that one, is very difficult challenge. I'll tell you, a very, very difficult challenge. Now, you can't tell, oh, I don't know this one. But suppose as a round the world, suppose they are telling and you, as a coach, you don't know about that, then definitely you're in trouble inside. I tell you that one. You need to know. You need to know. That's why I'm telling you. You need to spend your, as a coach, you can't spend your time in 2 hours in practice session and you forgot everything. As a coach, you need to, like a 24 hours coach. As a coach, you need to spend your time. You need to understand and children. And that is, then you can improve. That is the things is happening, not happening in India, I'll tell you. I'm going in outside country and definitely I saw in their progress and all those things. Why they are happening, that is the things. They are spending more time in ground inside, morning and evening. And coaches are know each and everybody. They are, how they are behavior and all those things. Because of that, in more match, when you play in more matches, then you can understand their confident level. And then their agility, each and everything. As a coach, you can know. But then suppose monthly, 3 months once, you go for in any tournament or any matches. But you as a coach, you don't know about their confident level, their communication, each and everything. You can't, don't know. As a coach, you don't know that one. Then, because of that, starting only, I told, more tournament and more matches need to play. That is, in weekly once, you need to play one good competition match. Then they can improve their confident level.
So, Ashwin, I hope you got your answers, and we will also be working on these skills while you are a part of the course that we are providing. So, I'll be telling you how to build rapport at a psychological level, how to work on that. So, don't worry. You got an answer from an experienced player. So, Gautam, one thing that I had in my mind, that you are saying that you should customize your entire drill to particular athlete you are trying to coach. So how do you scale in that case? Because if you are focusing only on one student at a time, either you provide a very high priced product or you need to think on scalability. So as a business, how do you manage this customization versus scalability?
See, that's why in our academy, what I'm doing now, making a label, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, how is the school, is the level is there. Suppose you're not in overcome that level, then definitely you should be in a level 1 only. You can't achieve in level 2. See, That's why I'm telling you, as a coach, you need to make in a like a step by step, one level. Suppose you're like a Sarah is telling about that one is a need to share that Excel sheet. That's why I'm given that example. Suppose in push, I'm talking about in first 1 month, your topics is there in pushing, push, how to a good trap and pass. Suppose your topic is that one. So as a coach, you need to work with them that 1 month. They are supposing they are boarding also, you need to work different way. So push in different type of is push. Suppose you're running and coming in a trapping your ball and pushing. Suppose you one cone you're keeping and turning and you're doing that one, that is also okay. You need to do different type of session. And finally, whatever your chapter is there, suppose in a normal push and pass. Your push and pass in a, that is in very easy method. Suppose that one, suppose they are not learning, you need to keep on do that one. Next month also same things, but drill session should be in a different. And finally, they are when they are achieved, and then they can go for in second level. They like that. In every level, you need to keep, and your level of practice and intention of practice should be in a different level. You need to change.
So, do you provide group classes in that case? Because or individual entire group
no,
classes and
few players are there. Suppose they are. I'm talking about flat foot. Suppose they are very good in push and trapping, but they are in a fully in a flat foot. They are easily very poor, and they are suppose in a, they are very fatty. What I am doing now? They are making a differentiation, fully differentiation. That is one to one session. Supposing that is as a coach or as a you're chargeable, but why that is in chargeable? Suppose in one tuition education purpose. Suppose you are in not good in math. What you're doing, parents are doing in one teacher, they are coming in individually and they're teaching that one. Same thing, same way. You need to call them, you need to tell them that is the lacking things is there. Their agility is very poor, they are in flat footed, they are not turning in a proper. I need to do in individual training and you need to spend your time in that one. That's it. And suppose you're showing their progress, definitely as a parent, 2,000, 3,000. Nowadays, if people are spending that one also. Easily, they can spend. No problem. But you need to show their progress. Otherwise, they are blast you. That's why I'm telling you, as a coach, you need to spend your more time.
Like, Gautam sir, this is what I was asking you. Because what's happened, person is making progress is one thing. And we have to show the progress to their parents. That's the second thing.
Yeah.
So for that we require some benchmarking and let's say some Excel sheets or some worksheets so that we can full on daily basis or weekly basis and we can share with the parents because temperature is one thing and the thermometer is the another thing. you understand my point?
Yes, so
we need both. then only we recognize the utility of this thing.
Yes, so this
is the one thing. And the other thing, I request you that you have spent a good time in this for the kids and the lower level of football thing. But my second request to you is that because Bangalore and Hyderabad both are the corporate hub, and all the corporate guys nowadays are playing cricket or let's say some indoor games. So we can start pushing some football as well to those guys. So that will be some.
No, definitely. And that is the things is happened. Definitely is happened. Cricket is a not in physically, they are not in too active. Suppose you're as a suppose I'm talking about in as a parent, suppose you're telling me anything in the about that one, I'll definitely push my son in football only. Why? They are sitting, they are in a school inside, they are spending in time 8 to 9 hours, they are coming here home, and they are again suppose you're spending in a time in 2 or 3 hours. Definitely they are in big problem inside. Definitely as a parent, I am sending in a ground. My son is now in 18 years boy, and he is in 12th standard. What I'm doing, suppose I'm telling you, see, he's very too much pressure is there. He is in PCMC. What I'm telling you, once you come in a college, definitely our my own ground is there. I'm spending in a, I'm telling you, you go 40 minutes, go with ball, you enjoy in ground inside, you play sometime, you spend your time, you sweat in ground inside, definitely you can come and you can get in more energy in home inside.
Absolutely, sports are extremely important for a healthy life, and it improves your mental power as well.
Yes, right.
You need to read parents' mind also, and you need to tell them also. See, that is the things is happening. And suppose you are not doing, then definitely next year you in big trouble inside. And definitely, that's why I think in a Bangalore, more than 100 ground is there in small side. I'm talking about in 5 side, 7 side. More than 100 ground are there now in Bangalore. They are in football now.
Super, they are definitely,
yeah, that is that one. Our group is there in sports on our arena group is there, and there I think more than 230 people are there. They are all are like a what I'm telling you, like a badminton arena or football arena. More than 100 arena are there now in football.
That's amazing to know. So Gautam, how do you handle injuries? Like, because in football, I think injuries are extremely common, and especially when the kids are trying to push the ball with their head and they don't know the impact it is getting on their brain. So how do you handle injuries, and how do you teach the parents that injuries, that how they can handle their kids with injuries?
Yeah, see, first of all, I'm telling you, that's why as a coach, below 12 years, heading practice is not there. I mean, FIFA is telling about that one, and that is criminal work. You should not do that one. But in match, mm-hmm. sometimes they are hitting that any injury. See, football, what I'll tell you, like a body contact game. And you need to tell them in parents, see, that is the situation is happened. And that is the things is happened in before only. That's why is a parents-teacher meeting is a very, very important thing. Suppose as a parent, I know about that is in physical game, and like that in injury happen, then definitely mind setup also is like that. Mind setup is like that, okay, like that in small injury, that is the, they can recover. That's why you need to talk with your parents, and injury is there. Definitely injury is there. See, my, I think two-time ligament injury, back injury is there, quadriceps too. Two, both the legs and quadriceps, and tear is there. That is definitely is there. When you play in a long, almost in 22 years, your football career, definitely injury is there. But you need to do like what I'll tell you. My suggestion is a insurance, 1-3 to 4 lakhs or 5 lakhs, one insurance. Compulsory, you need to do that one. Definitely you need to do that one. That is in small children, you should not think about that. That is behind, you need to do as a sports center or sports academy. You need to talk with your parents, and you need to do one insurance. Then they are in safer side. Definitely injuries there. And every sports, but in football, little more. See, sometime in muscle cramp and all those things is there. Definitely one good physio is very, very important in one sports football career. You need to do that. That is there. Definitely is there.
Absolutely. So are you also working on providing psychologic trainings for the coaches? Because nowadays we have come to this realization that psychology is an extremely big part. As so are you also working on those things for your coaches? Yes. Like how are you working on that? You would like to
see, every 15 days we are sitting in all the coaches. Our academy near about 17 coaches are there. And Sunil and Emmanuel, they are sitting with, and I'm also sitting with them and talking with them. Definitely, psychology is a very, very big factor now. Big factor. I'm talking about one boy is there. His name in Rancho. He's very good. But when he's starting in a match, he's not able to do his skill and all those things. That time, you need to give their best. And you need to psychology that time, you need to implement. All those things. Definitely, psychology nowadays is a very, very important. Why no? They are in school and all those area. There is too much pressure is there. And that purpose, that things is happening. But before our time, where is the psychology and all those things? We are not thinking about that. We are playing in every day, I think, 3-4 matches. We are not thinking about that. But now, definitely pressure is there. Definitely different other way pressure is there. And sometime in children are, I suppose, parents are working. Both are is working in that type of, children are more in that into that because of that. You need to work. You definitely, that is one like a one chapter. You need to teach them nicely Why no? You can't talk in a rudely in ground. So that's why I'm telling you, you all should be in 24 hours coach. You need to understand in children point. Sometime in the that children home inside, nobody is there. He's spending in the time in ground. Inside. Suppose you're talking in a very rudely, definitely he upset. Definitely. That is I need to do. That is definitely you need to work that one.
Yeah, nowadays you're not allowed to even shout at the kid. And I even remember my school days when the PT teacher was known for only one work.
Yeah,
to
yeah.
get the boy who is making all the snottiest boy and beat him up. So
yeah,
we
yeah.
were all scared of our PT teacher at that time. But fortunately, yeah. things have changed. And now we are trying to be more understanding towards the kids.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Any last questions for Gautam, because I think we have taken up a lot of your time and we have got some really amazing answers. So still, if somebody wants to ask some last question. Anyone? Okay, so that's all the questions we'll ask from you today, Gautam. Thank you so much for the wonderful session. And I'll request Ravi sir to say something for you. Ravi sir.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Pratista. And Gautam, it was very nice being on our show. And then, as Sachin was discussing, we would want to try to help you and then get help from you as well to promote sports, as you're doing a very noble cause of promoting soccer in, for almost like 400 kids in Bangalore. So Sachin will talk to you about getting collaboration, and then we wanted to start your activities here in Hyderabad also. I mean, due to this pandemic and the lockdown, it's a little unfortunate situation right now, but hopefully this will get better soon, and then
yeah.
try to get forward as well.
Definitely, sir. Yeah, you can. That is the thing. So, is a exchange program is very, very important. Exchange program, coaches and children. Exchange program is a very, very important. One academy in different coaches, different session. Suppose they are doing in that exchange program, definitely they can improve their performance.
So, Krista is working on a coaches training program. Well, probably she will take a couple of minutes and then explain you. Probably you can be part of our mentor team, and then we can train people in Bangalore as well. So, I think she will be able to explain. Thank you so much, Krista.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you for calling me.
Sure, sir. Take few more minutes and explain the program that we have started. I'll
yeah.
just explain the program. One second, it is open. Please let me know once you are able to see my screen.
Yeah, we're
able to see you
better.
Yeah.
Yeah. So SMC has come up with this program for the future of sports and coaching, because we know that how important it is for having coaches who are well equipped with all the knowledge. So the questions we had in mind was, can a good player always be a good coach? Well, we believe that they can, but they need a lot of training for that. So,
yes.
And a coach does plays a significant role in the life of an athlete. Today, Gautam, you mentioned clearly that for the coach is the first role model the child is having for their sports. So we came to know through researches that 90% of the youth sport coaches are untrained. And to succeed during these times, you need to do things differently. So we are working on getting these coaches to this up to the skills, so that people are not scared, because people with skills are actually not scared, and taking all these things in consideration, that we need future coaches who are well equipped, who have the knowledge, and who are not untrained. In fact, they're trained in an advanced level. We have come up with this program, which is a 3-month intensive coach program. Now, what will be taught in this program? It will be the first thing is it will be completely online, and there will be key concepts in reference to ITF and Olympics. Here we will be understanding the core of coaching, the mindset of a coach, because a coach needs to have a slightly different mindset when compared to an athlete. The coach's mindset needs to be a more holistic view. So we will be working on what exactly will be the mindset of a coach that a coach needs to possess. Then we will be working on advanced communication skills. Like Gautam, today you mentioned again and again that we need to have advanced communication skills. The coach needs to always communicate, build rapport. So we will be working on these skills along with developing problem solving skills and how to do a continuous improvement, how to work on ISO 9000 standards. Along with that, we had some bonuses that we are offering. Like there will be exclusive webinars by industry experts every week. Then there will be special session with Mr. Nadeem, who is an Indian hockey player. I am a mind and memory coach, so I will be providing a special counseling session to understand individual problems. Like you mentioned, the need that we need to know the individual problem of, as a coach. So I will be taking up that, because coaches also need coaches. So as a coach, what problems a specific coach is facing, that I will address, and I'll help them out through the specific problem. Then there is a proper more than 1 hour of recorded session on goal smashing mindset that we are providing. And there is a special Facebook closed group which all the students will be joining. This will help them in networking as well, because the people who will be in that group, they will be like an alumni network. So they will be there for each other, and they can help each other. Every time they have a problem, they can just consult within the Facebook group by networking. So this is a program that we are offering, and I'm not going into the pricing thing right now, because I was just focusing on the program that we have come up with, and I would like to introduce you to that course. That's all I wanted to tell you, that we are coming up with this course. The classes are starting next week, and we would be very happy if any of your coaches also would like to do a program with us. You can get in contact with Ravi sir. We would like to take it forward. We would be very happy.
Definitely, you can share all those things, then definitely I share within our coaches also.
Absolutely, and we really enjoyed the session today, with sharing your personal experiences and the knowledge that you have gathered over a period of a decade. That was priceless. So thank you so much for sharing, and we hope to work with you very soon. Just like Ravi sir said, that we need to collaborate and make this industry like little different from what it is right now. So we will be looking forward to working with you.
Definitely.
Thank you so much. Sincere gratitude from the team. Have a good day.
Yeah, thank you. Take care, everybody. Yeah.
Yeah. Bye, thank bye. You. Thank you, Gautam, sir.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
This is a wonderful session again.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I think we can rejoin another call, or we can let Yashwant go. Yashwant, thank you so much for attending the session and being there for every session. Really appreciate.
Thank you, ma'am.
Uh,